myself, we sleep at night, which works wonderfully well. Anyway, on that happy note, I'm now going to hand over to Valerie to give her a little input.
Thank you. As John said, I know him 11 years I had the gallery open in Kilkenny, and he's been exhibiting with me for 11 years. And before we even talk about the beautiful body of work, I mean, it's the first time I've seen it on the wall. I've seen images, and I know John's work, but I just think this is fabulous, John. Really, really amazing. And it's taken a lot. John's had a very bad, very tough year, health-wise, and you know, he's one of those people, he's a brilliant artist himself, but he's also a huge support to the to every other artist and any other artistic body, myself included. He's a great supporter to us all. So it's amazing to have heard all about this work, and then now to see it on the walls is just fantastic. But if we were to start at a point, I suppose, really, in this corner, that is just the epitome of John, the board with the influences and always thinking of other people. John has put that up so you can see and have a little bit of insight into John's work and what influences him. And that, I suppose, is the starting point of the exhibition. This corner area here is the retrospective part, leading on further to newer works and the piece de resistance and the beginning of the end and the beginning of everything else is on this corner, up in the air, really. So I'm going to talk really a little bit from this perspective onwards. So as I said, John, as always, thinking of others, provides us with a very interesting selection of images here, giving us some insight as to what drives him, what's important to him, and what and who has influenced him. A picture of Norway, very unusual picture of Norway there in the far pram in the forest. Images from his sketchbook, references to his early influences, such as, well, to start with John Mondrian, would have been the beginning, the earliest of influences for you. And, actually Matisse, and then Mondrian, and later Kandinsky. And actually, if you looked, if I'm not sure if you're familiar with Kandinsky's work, but there's a huge influence, always and always has been, in your work of that particular painter, the use of colour and the layering. So Norway plays a hugely influential part in John's work, in the past, and not quite so obviously, but still in the present. His love of the Norwegian landscape, oftentimes reflected and mirrored in the Irish landscape, which you can see again around the room, moving from the literal to the very abstract work on that end. In the retrospective section, the images of landscape where John has dealt with the theme very literally. For example, these pieces here, the lovely in my dreams, not that one, John, oh, it's just so beautiful. Such beautiful use of colour. Again, we can see the influence of Matisse in the simple forms and the striking colours. There are so many reasons to talk about each piece, but of course we don't have time for that. Of particular interest here are the lovely works of Norway, the beautiful view of Rosslare, as you approach Ireland by ferry, which... which is actually a very nostalgic piece for you, but for Irish people as well, because especially those returning home, that would have been the first thing they would see coming into Rosslare. So it's a beautiful, nostalgic and literal piece in that retrospective area. My favourite is this little gem in your dreams. Yeah, that is absolutely beautiful. But I suppose central to the show is the middle section, and it's a series of five long pieces which John has named Variation on a Theme. Now, this is the most unusual and very striking format and shape. The shape and the length of the piece is hugely complementary to the subject of each painting. So the idea for the shape
came from a collection of ancient Chinese silk paintings, which are very, very long, and something like scrolls, actually. And they're kept in the museum, in the Chinese Museum in Beijing. And every 10 years, these paintings are rolled out. And that's what's influenced the length of these. So those Chinese paintings, ancient paintings, tell us are quite historic. They tell historical stories. And these really tell, are, I suppose, if you read them, they are to John, the Irish landscape. They're very abstracted, but yet, in each piece, you can see the arches of trees, the curve of a hill, the way the sunlight, you know, moves across a mountain. All of that is evident in these works, and they're really, really beautiful. They're so much nicer in the flesh than I've seen on images, so I think they're amazing. So the subject, again, in John's pieces is the Irish landscape. And these pieces are loosely tied to John's place of residence, the Leanne Valley, where we can see a more abstracted body of work here, and yet we can see the beautiful curves of the hills, the arches of the trees, and the colour of the sunlight, as I said, in my opinion, that's what I see anyway, looking at them. And the final part of the show is made up of several works that are very abstract at the end. So these actually came after, and one of those in particular, the middle piece, is one of John's favourites. So, abstract 1, 2, and 3, and the lovely Seconds Comes to Town, which really evokes memories of the big top, that blue piece on the right, the big top and the colours and the excitement of the circus. You can feel it in it, you nearly feel and hear the crowd inside that. It's just so beautiful. I think this is probably the most complete body of John's work I've ever seen. It encompasses everything I love about his work. The palette he uses, the loose abstraction of landscape, and it really ends with a majestic piece. The first oil painting I've ever seen John produce, which is up here on the wall. So I've never seen John paint in oils, but really from the beginning to the very end is this piece. And John has painted it on a very old covered door. And there are, again, his usual influence in there, but also a little bit of Rothko creeping in. And I think it's extraordinary to come from, to be such a versatile artist that you can express yourself literally and then express yourself so beautifully in an abstracted way, the way he has, and that we can all understand, because sometimes abstract art is just, you just don't quite get it. You know, it's not for everybody, but I think there isn't anything here that people couldn't live with or couldn't enjoy or couldn't find something extremely engaging in each piece. So this being the last one is really the beginning of John's future, I think. I think there's going to be so much more and so much more in oil, which is a pity because of the quality of the watercolour, but I've always thought for somebody who can produce a depth of colour in watercolour, as John has, it's very rare. I've always wondered why he hasn't gone here, and yet here we are. So as he said to me the other day, you know, he feels now that it's only now he's starting to get somewhere in his painting himself, and maybe to reach a new place, and that is it up there. So from a commercial point of view, I would say if you're buying, go for that one first. this is the galleries coming out to me, but it's a hugely successful show, and I wish him all the best. I hope it's a commercially successful show. John has invested a huge amount of time and money and effort into the show, so really why the commercial aspect is never something an artist thinks about. It's something I would think about for the artist, because I know the work and the dedication and the hours that go into each piece. So I hope it's a success on all levels. As far as I'm concerned, and as far as you're concerned, John, it's a success on the walls as is. So with that, I declare the show open. Thank you very much.